For the first time since our solar system was born billions of years ago, a strange space body has gotten past its boundaries, putting our planet and its neighbors at risk of destruction. Could this be one of the many objects floating in near-Earth space, or have our long-speculated interstellar visitors begun surfacing? For the longest time, scientists have been worried that somewhere up there exists something we are yet to explore and understand. Aliens, galaxy-eating black holes, and regions with too intense gravity. Although there have been many visits to outer space and countless hours of study dedicated by scientists to studying the occurrences and objects in space, no evidence to affirm the existence of any alien species has been found. But that changed on the 19th of October 2017, when an interstellar object was observed to have made it into our solar system for the very first time. Space bodies have never entered our solar system. They typically get to the verge at best, but getting past our solar system and close enough to be detected by instruments on Earth doesn't happen every other day. At least, not for decades. Our scientists have religiously studied space. So, when a strange object was picked up by the Canadian physicist and astronomer Robert Weryk at the Haleakala Observatory in Hawaii, already advancing in its journey after making its way into our solar system, scientists began asking questions. Could this be our long-speculated extraterrestrial intelligent life? Here's what we've come to know about this stranger in our solar system. Oumuamua is Hawaiian for messenger from a distant past. And this is the name the Pan-STARRS team assigned to this first interstellar object found in our solar system. Since scientists witnessed the presence of an object from outside our star system for the first time, Oumuamua came as a unique problem for the International Astronomical Union, the body responsible for assigning designations to astronomical objects. Deciding exactly what this strange object was would not come easy, and we can't say we've unraveled all there is to know about Oumuamua, since the identity of this interstellar visitor is still shrouded in mystery. Oumuamua was initially classified as a comet, but was eventually found not to be. All comets have an envelope of gas and dust surrounding their core, referred to as a coma, and when acted on by the sun's radiation pressure and blown by the solar winds, the result is the formation of a long tail that points away from the sun. So when scientists couldn't find a coma around Oumuamua, it was easy to tell this wasn't one of the over 4,000 comets in our solar system. So, could Oumuamua be one of the many million asteroids in our solar system? Scientists later believed that Oumuamua could be an asteroid. Asteroids have a rocky exterior, so when scientists found Oumuamua's outer surface to be rocky, the obvious move was to designate it as an asteroid. However, Oumuamua was found to be anything but an asteroid when it sped past the Sun at a speed of over 196,000 miles per hour, an acceleration that the Sun's gravitational pull alone cannot account for. What then could this visitor to our solar system be? Perhaps looking carefully at its features could give us an answer to where this visitor originated from or what exactly it is. Observations to ascertain Oumuamua's composition and shape were carried out using the VLT, the Gemini South telescopes, and the Hawaiian Keck 2 telescope, all very powerful telescopes. However, this strange visitor's exact shape and composition are, at the very best, just models scientists have come up with. The precise composition of Oumuamua still remains unknown. This is because Oumuamua's speed provided scientists with an amount of time too limited to carry out any exhaustive studies. Weryk first took notice of Oumuamua barely less than a week after it had come closest to Earth, as far as about 60 times the distance from the Earth to the Moon. This was already a month after Oumuamua had made it past the perihelion, where it came closest to the Sun. In less than 4 months, our interstellar visitor had already traveled far beyond the reach of our most powerful ground-based telescopes. By January 2018, scientists would be left struggling with just glimpses of the stranger on its journey away from our solar system. However, in the short period available for scientists to study Oumuamua, they were able to carry out 800 observations. By measuring the light it reflected, scientists could come up with light curves that gave a clue to Oumuamua's shape, size, and how it rotated in space. Scientists concluded from the dips and rises of the light curves obtained from their studies that Oumuamua's length is roughly between 300 and 3,000 feet long, with width and thickness ranging between 115 and 148 feet. And while most objects that originate within our solar system have a width-to-length ratio of 1:3, Oumuamua is estimated to have a width-to-length ratio within the range of 1:6 and 1:10, as adjudged from the light studies carried out by scientists. Further studies of the light curves obtained using the VLT and Halley's telescope indicated that Oumuamua is coloured red, similar to comet nuclei or Trojans. It is also believed to be an elongated object, although we can't tell its exact shape since even our most powerful telescopes picked up Oumuamua as just a point source of light. However, scientists have said it is highly likely that Oumuamua is shaped somewhat like a long cigar or an extremely flat pancake. Additional findings from Oumuamua's light curve have suggested that it may be made up of dense rocks which are rich in metals and red from being exposed to cosmic rays for millions of years. Its surface is believed to contain a substance called tholin, an irradiated organic compound commonly found in objects originating from outside our star system, and which can be used to tell the age of their surface. Some scientists say that Oumuamua could be technology developed by alien life. Others argue it could be one of the remains from a disintegrated rogue comet, or even a piece from an exoplanet enriched with nitrogen ice, like Pluto. Oumuamua's motion was observed to be more of a tumbling rather than a spinning one. Scientists could not fit Oumuamua's trajectory into a solar orbit, so it became apparent that this interstellar visitor was just passing through our solar system. It is believed that our solar system is most likely the first planetary system Oumuamua has closely encountered since it was released, possibly billions of years back, from its star system of origin. Judging from the many critical observations carried out on the path traced by Oumuamua during the course of its journey, it is believed that Oumuamua must have originated from the direction of the star Vega, which happens to be the brightest star in the constellation Lyra. Although conclusive evidence would be needed to tell that Oumuamua originated from beyond the shores of our star system, scientists would finally discover good evidence not too long after. After 80 days of carefully studying how Oumuamua travelled around our solar system, it was discovered that the eccentricity of this object was way above that of any other object observed previously within our solar system. Oumuamua had an orbital eccentricity of 1.2. This was astonishing because up until scientists picked up Oumuamua traveling in our solar system, the highest observed eccentricity value was attributed to the comet C1980E1, a comet whose eccentricity was found to be slightly greater than 1. Based on the definition for this parameter, scientists judged that an eccentricity greater than 1 is only obtainable by an object with a velocity greater than that of the Sun's escape velocity, one that is not confined to our solar system and that's capable of escape into interstellar space. While it's typical for objects with eccentricities slightly greater than 1 to originate from encounters with planets within our solar system, Oumuamua's eccentricity was just too high for it to be placed in this category of objects. Even if there were undiscovered planets in our solar system, which could have made for a valid argument, Oumuamua's eccentricity was way too high to have originated from an encounter with any planet within our solar system. So, by mid-November, scientists were confident that this object had originated from outside our solar system, an interstellar visitor indeed. Oumuamua's visit to our solar system was lightning fast, and with the best of our instruments and the available technology at our disposal, scientists could probe as best they could within the window period of Oumuamua's short stay. At best, we are left still guessing what Oumuamua really is, and there is no conclusive evidence to prove that Oumuamua is a product of intelligent life outside of our planet. In January 2022, scientists came up with a proposal to launch the Project Lyra. Project Lyra brought forward the notion that if a spacecraft is launched from Earth, it could get close enough to Oumuamua in 26 years for better close-up studies.